Government of India has denied knowing about the alleged surveillance of phones of over 20 Indians. The Government of India has in fact told Times Network through sources that WhatsApp never highlighted or disclosed the privacy breach to them. Sources further clarified that the spyware software Pegasus has not been purchased by any ministry of the Indian government. Let's go straight to Right, we'll try and connect with Bhavtosh Padia. This is big breaking news now. The government in fact now saying through sources that as far as they're concerned, they did not know about this. They were not notified by the company. Let's go straight to Bhavtosh Singh, who brings us the story. Bhavtosh, so what are you learning from your sources about where the government stands in their own? Because the government certainly is facing a few questions. The people who've been subject to these to this surveillance have been pointing the finger straight at the government. Okay, we'll try and reconnect with Bhavtosh there. We seem to have some audio troubles, but just to quickly tell you what we are now learning. In fact, the government says, through sources, we're now learning the government says they want to make social media platform answerable. The issue, they say, is of traceability of the malicious information. The government also says that never once did WhatsApp highlight or disclose the issue that was declared in front of them to a U.S. court. Bhavtosh is standing by. Bhavtosh, if you can explain to us what you have learned through your sources about what the government's stand officially is, because WhatsApp claims they informed the government. The government doesn't seem to agree with that.
Viren, as far as the government is concerned, yesterday government sources said that twice senior executives of WhatsApp and Facebook came and met them. At no point of time they raised the issue that there is a malware in WhatsApp, which is the hacking into it, which was a phone, and thus carrying out snooping activities. But later in the day, the Facebook and also WhatsApp hit back at the government, clearly mentioning that in May they had informed the government about possible security breach inside WhatsApp. They have mentioned two instances. One, they have said that even in the lawsuit that they had filed before a California court, they have specifically mentioned that the law enforcing agencies of specific country have been informed. More importantly, they have also mentioned that the government's own website, CERTIN, which is Computer Emergency Response Team Network of the government of India, it specifically mentioned on 17th of May 2019 that there is a possible security breach in WhatsApp, and they have mentioned specifically that the malware will automatically download photographs and also will breach data. That's what WhatsApp is saying, that government was aware that, that there was a security breach and it was kept in loop. However, the government continues to maintain that it was a general alert issued by WhatsApp, and at no point of time they mentioned about the Pegasus malware.
Right, and you know, Bhavtosh, then what is their response to this picture that we've now accessed, which clearly shows that this was, as you mentioned, up on the government's own website. This is not as if, you know, it's been somehow found through, you know, other means. The fact of the matter is the government themselves put up this information that there was a breach on the WhatsApp platform. Have you got any response to that?
Well, Viren, the question is whether government was aware of the security breach. A second more important question is that who will install such a expensive software? Was it a government agency or whether it was a private agency? The fact that people who have been are people who have been working for Dalit rights and also for human rights as well as for tribals. Some have suspected links with Maoists. So the question that needs to be answered by the government is as to who, in fact, in the country, because the website clearly mentioned one thing. The Minister website clearly mentioned it's only government that can, government agencies can use the software. Government on its part has said that it's not aware of all this, but WhatsApp has specifically mentioned that in May, they had alerted the government about possible malware as well hacking within the system.
Right, Steve Das Bhavtosh, because I've got Pawan Dugal, who's a cybersecurity expert, who joins us on the phone line. Thanks so much, Mr. Dugal, for speaking to us this morning. You know, the government, through sources, in fact, trying to deny that they had any involvement, they had any knowledge of this breach. The WhatsApp, though, says they informed the government. You know, the fact that the company that produced the software says that it's extremely expensive, what does that tell you about who perhaps could have been wielding the power of this Pegasus software?
I think it's going to be a combination of various state and non-state actors who could ultimately be wielding the power. A plan would have been made to target India. Why? Because India is a very fertile jurisdiction. No data protection law in the country. No cybersecurity law in the country. No known convictions of any cybersecurity breaches. So all this must have encouraged these various state and non-state actors to go ahead and target per se. Now, in case WhatsApp version yesterday night has to be believed that it has informed the governmental agencies, then a big question comes across, why was the government silent? When all throughout, the government has been maintaining that it was asking for a reply from WhatsApp. Clearly, if different arms of the government are not talking to each other, that's a massive disconnect, and that is a massive signal for all cybersecurity breaches to say, hold on, here is a fantastic opportunity to go ahead and target India. But I think the learning from this is very, very clear. Why is it taking such a long period of time to register an FIR in the country? Why, when this is such a matter of immense national importance, where so-called unauthorized surveillance and monitoring has taken place without the specific sanction under Section 69 of the Information Technology Act 2000? What has really mandated, stopped the government from taking action against both these entities of WhatsApp and the Israeli company, because both of them become intermediaries under Section 21W of the Information Technology Act 2000? They are called upon, and they should be called upon to demonstrate how they have exercised due diligence to prevent the commission of any offense or contravention. On the other hand, the said acts themselves are symbolic of various offenses committed under the Information Technology Act 2000, as also under the Indian Penal Code. So at a time when the privacy is at a premium, and at a time when the government, after the Puttaswamy judgment, is enjoined to protect the privacy of citizens, such kind of unauthorized surveillance could potentially put the government into serious potential legal exposure, because people are going to sue the government left, right, and center under the writ jurisdiction, primarily because the state failed right in its responsibility to protect them.
Right, and Mr. Dugal, you know, one more thing that I put, the question I put to Bhavtosh as well, which is we've got two things now. We've had WhatsApp say that, as far as they're concerned, they informed the government about such a breach. There was a post in the government's IT website where they spoke about the breach on the platform. The fact that, let's assume that this was a communication breakdown within the government and the higher-ups weren't actually notified about this breach that affects, even if it's 20, that's still a large number of individuals who are deemed to be important enough to be surveilled. That in and of itself, Mr. Dugal, isn't that also a concern?
That's a massive concern. Please understand, India cannot afford to just keep on offering lip service to cybersecurity. At a time when it's becoming the biggest e-commerce market in the world, you have to have your antennas up. And in case if such kind of an exercise takes place, at a time which is most opportune, at the time when the elections are taking place, the antennas needed to be even more up. And in any case, specific explanations need to be sought from WhatsApp under the notification of the Computer Emergency Response Team of 4th of January, when they notified such cybersecurity breaches so that more details could be called for. But by and large, I think in the absence of a cybersecurity law, the urgency at a national level to dedicate resources, time, effort, and energies on cybersecurity is clearly missing. But that's the message that this particular episode needs to deliver as a wake-up call, that no longer can now we afford to just give lip service. We will have to quickly start addressing the challenges of cybersecurity breaches. Otherwise, tomorrow, it could potentially be impacting the sovereignty, security, and integrity of India.
Mr. Dugal, thanks much for your time and for taking us through all the details. As you also point out, the fact that we have no strong cybersecurity laws whatsoever, that leaves Indians vulnerable to these sorts of actors. Thanks, Mr. Dugal, for joining us, and thanks, Bhavtosh, bringing us that breaking information.